This is 10 News. The state government has been urged to bulldoze the Sydney Entertainment Centre. Business groups say the city's convention facilities are not coping with demand and the site should be redeveloped.
The Entertainment Centre has been an icon since it opened in 1983 and it's hosted some of the biggest acts in the world. Baby, you can drive my car. Over the years, millions have enjoyed a night out at a concert or sporting event.
60 seconds remaining.
But there's a new push to knock down the Entertainment Centre and the adjacent car park and replace them both with a single, larger, more flexible venue.
A multi-function facility, one where entertainment is integral, but one where we can have big conventions, big banquets, big events, and indeed as part of that you'd want to see a hotel.
That's causing concern among the resurgent Sydney Kings.
It's iconic in Sydney, just like we hope the Sydney Kings brand is, and with us returning we couldn't think of a better place to play than here, so we hope it's here for a long time to come.
But the centre is likely to be redeveloped following a review of the Darling Harbour precinct by the state government.
Looking at the availability of hotel space, of convention space, of other tourism facilities. That work is coming to a conclusion and is due to be released shortly.
Business groups warn Sydney is being left behind.
Sydney is missing out on some of the biggest and best conventions because we simply don't have the space to compete, and we don't compete with cities like Singapore and Melbourne because they've addressed this issue.
The government's expected to make a decision on the entertainment centre by the end of the year. John Hill, 10 News.